I welcome all of you boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, for our exploration now about colligative properties. The colligative properties depend on the number of moles of solute dissolved in a particular solution, and these properties do not vary with the nature of solute. For example, if I dissolve 1 mole of glucose or 1 mole of urea or 1 mole of sucrose, whatever I dissolve, as long as it is 1 mole in a fixed quantity of water, the boiling point of water increases exactly to same extent. There are 2 points here. Addition of a non-volatile solute is increasing the boiling point. I call this increment as elevation in boiling point. So, this elevation in boiling point is a colligative property. There are several such colligative properties. To list them, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and osmotic pressure. Okay, about relative lowering of vapor pressure, we have discussed in previous video. Raoult's law also relates that aspect, but the lowering of vapor pressure is certainly a colligative property. Now, we see what do we mean by other colligative properties. Now, if I take pure water, you can take for that matter any other liquid, but I am taking water. If I plot the variation in vapor pressure with the temperature, as I am rising temperature, its vapor pressure is increasing. But at a particular temperature, the vapor pressure of water is equal to 1 atmosphere. The temperature where the vapor pressure of water is 1 atmosphere is called normal boiling point, which is of course 100 degrees centigrade. Now, if I dissolve some amount of urea or any non-volatile solute, the vapor pressure of solution drops. It is lower than the vapor pressure of pure water at any given temperature. If this is the vapor pressure of pure water, at the same temperature, this is the vapor pressure of the solution which we are studying. Due to this fact, it requires a little higher temperature, more than 373 K, to achieve that 1 atmosphere pressure. Therefore, the boiling point of liquid is said to increase by this amount. This increment in the boiling point, from the study of these graphs, can be understood to be dependent on concentration of solute. I can say it is molality of the solution. More is the number of moles of solute dissolved, more is the molality, more is the elevation boiling point. To relate this, delta Tb is equal to a constant into m. This Kb is called as delta Tb is equal to Kb into m. This Kb is called molal elevation in boiling point constant. This is actually equal to elevation in boiling point if the solution is of 1 molal. Thermodynamics laws have shown that Kb is equal to RT0 divided by delta Hv, where R is universal gas constant, T0 is its normal boiling point in Kelvin scale, delta Hv is latent heat of vaporization. Therefore, a knowledge of the elevation boiling point of a solution and the Kb value of which is characteristic for a given liquid, can help you to know the molality of solution. In these three, if you know any two, third one can be known. Also, indirectly, it can be used to find the molecular weight of unknown solute. How? Because you know another relation, delta Tb is equal to Kb into weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of solvent. You know how many grams of solvent you have taken. You know what is the weight of solute you have dissolved. You have determined the elevation boiling point. You know the value of Kb. Then you can find the molar mass of solute. Any solute's molar mass can be computed using this relation. Similarly, you have another colligative property called depression in freezing point. That is, normally pure water freezes at 0 degrees centigrade. But if I dissolve some solute, freezing point becomes less than 0. It can be -1, -2, so on, depending on the amount of solute I dissolve. The depression freezing point, delta Tf, is also related to molality of the solution. Therefore, delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. This Kf is called molal depression in freezing point constant. For water, Kf is equal to 1.86 kkg per mole. Notice the units of Kf and Kb are same. kkg per mole. Kb is elevation in boiling point constant or ebulloscopic constant. And Kf is molar depression in freezing point constant or simply Kf, sometimes called cryoscopic constant. For different liquids, it has different values. For camphor, it has as much as 40 kkg per mole. Therefore, this depression freezing point can also be used to compute the molar mass of unknown solute. By using the same logic, delta Tb is equal to Kb into weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of solvent. You know weight of solvent which you have taken. You know weight of solute you dissolved. You know delta Tb experimentally. For a given solvent, Kb value is given. So, this Kb is also related to from thermodynamics laws to freezing point by RTF square by delta Hf, where delta Hf is called latent heat of fusion. Therefore, this depression freezing point data can also be used to compute the molar mass of a given solute. Finally, osmotic pressure, which is represented by pi. When a certain concentrated solution is separated from a diluted solution through a semi-permeable membrane, the skin of tomato, skin of potato, animal skins, parchment paper, all they are called semi-permeable membrane. When a concentrated solution is separated from a diluted solution through a semi-permeable membrane, then the solvent molecules naturally tend to flow through the semi-permeable membrane from diluted solution to concentrated solution. To stop this flow of liquid, sometimes you have to apply external pressure. The amount of pressure required to stop this flow is called osmotic pressure. The phenomena where liquid is flowing like that is called osmosis. And osmotic pressure measurements provide the excellent method to find the molar mass of a given solute. This osmotic pressure is something like pressure of an ideal gas, which obeys PV is equal to NTR relation. It is also PV is equal to NTR. where pi is osmotic pressure, V is volume of solution, N is the number of moles of solute dissolved, T is the temperature, R is the universal gas constant. Sometimes it can be said pi is equal to NTS, where R is equal to S. So, this can be rearranged like pi V is equal to weight of solute by molar weight into T into universal solution constant, which is same as gas constant. You can take M this side, V this side. Pi m is equal to weight by volume into Ts. Weight by volume is nothing but density. So, all these relationships can be used to compute the molar mass of a given solute. Of all the methods, osmotic pressure provides the best method to know the molar mass of a given solute. At this moment, this is all. Thank you very much.